Right, good afternoon. Today I actually want to talk about disappointment. I want to talk about the disappointment person in my family, personal disappointment, but I imagine many of you have the same application that goes on through in your life also. My brother, for instance, a change of heart with me, change of heart, you know, and to the point of a non claimant to my existence, actually. More of, I'm just a person on the street to him, you know. It has turned into this kind of aggravant situation of relationship, and I'm not clear as to why. In the many years of my life, he's been a major impression. He's been important, been absolute important character that I've always depended upon. So, and I have always had this, like, as my what do we call it? I don't want to equate it to financial. And I mean the support of a friend that will always be there. And so now he has turned on me, you know, turned on me just as quickly as a pancake that is burned. And so I'm wondering, okay, so where has this happened? You know, where has this come from? Have I done something? Have I done something incredible? Incredible that has ruined the relation? I have never fit in like the others. I am not like the others in his particular experience with women. I'm his sister. I am his sister, and I will always be that. And in many respects, no, I am not a professional that he would hire for a career, for a job. And he's told me this throughout my lifetime. So in this build, I've been like, well, I'm your sister. I'm your sister. And so I expect that respect in continuance. You have given me this leadership role, even now through my life, to be advice, to be this help to many people on the planet, and yet you are turning against me and expecting me to have a full turnabout and be reactive and be a conglomeration as the others. And throw everything of my training, of my youth, of my childhood, of my experience with other human beings away, as a non-essential, a non-essential gift to the other human beings on the planet. So I am kind of upset because I'm feeling degraded by him, after so many years where he has lifted me up, as to be something major. And superior, he has now taken the carpet and out from underneath my pedestal, and to a terrible place, an accusatory. So he's begun the accusatory with me. So when they start the accusatory, I start to go, well, wait a minute, what's the reason for accusatory? You know, why accuse me? Is there something that you want? Is there something financial that you're not getting? Is there a financial equipment that is also a requirement of the relationship at this particular time in my life, you know, just before 50? I'm supposed to have some financial equipment to supply you as a friend, as a brother. And I didn't think that was a requirement in all my years. I never thought this was a requirement. I figured that it was a brotherly love situation, my greatest, oldest brother, and he'll always be there. Is just like, you can even say the stability of a government building. He's just there, you know. He's just my friend that I can talk to. But then yet I'm getting the opposite. I'm getting like a turn face, like he wants me to be equipped with other labels of hurt. He's throwing hurt labels at me, you know. You are this, or you are that, or you need this type of help, or blah, blah, blah. Because I am not because I'm not acting as a regular woman who just wants to go out and work at the 7-Eleven, because I am different. I feel like he is acting that particular, that he is throwing now all of a sudden, what did we call it, the feminism role at me, with a huge wave. For many years I have been pretty much just a housewife. And now it's like the rainfall of feminism on me, and I'm like in a state of shock, and I need him to be supportive and even help me find a mate, you know. And yet it is an extravagant no, not to get married, no, not to go find a partner, no boyfriend for you. I'm getting this action from him, and it is an incredulous non-gift. It's an incredulous hatred toward me, as if, why, you know, what's wrong? Why can't I have a relationship that I've lived so many years, you know, 20 years plus in marriage? Why can't I have this again? Or why can't I have at least a boyfriend? You know, he's in this slaying of it. The slaying of this moment, and I'm, you know, no, just go somewhere, and then I'm telling him I can't work anywhere, because they have credit report checks everywhere, and now my credit has been destroyed. I'm like, I can't even just waltz into the Neiman Marcus and start fluttering the eyeball lashes, extraordinary, and for the squirt sniff of the fragrance, I can't do that either. You know, even though that's not required, I'm advice. I'm a guru, also. You know, that is really I'm here for that, and yet I'm not getting the support. I'm getting like, no, you just go be, what? You know, the non-trained, the manual labor. I'm not manual labor. I've not been brought up that way, and he is responsible for that. He is majorly responsible. He is an absolute propagator of who I am today. So for him to flip on me and turn into another person, I have to wonder why, you know. And so I'm looking. Well, is he taking drugs? Is there something that he is trying to protect? Is he trying to protect himself? You know, is he getting some payment? And when I'm saying that, the payment of sometimes is addiction. There is the addiction to continue. And what is that addiction? You know, is the addiction, is it a drug? Is it an alcohol? Is it the fact that I don't support him drinking? Is that it also? You know, I'm not the extravagant drinker, teetotaler type. That's one of my major avoidances for even going to California, is exactly that. You know, I can't handle the free pouring alcohol. So is that it? Is that where we are? Is that where we are with our relationship? The alcohol is not allowed to be poured anywhere near us, and so our friendship is severed? Is that what's going on? And so, in preference, you denounce me and promote me to a lesser than immigrant status, what do we call them? The aliens from Mexico that walk across the border, in job work fashion. That's where you are promoting me to. That demotion. Negligent my intelligence. I'm absolutely appalled, actually. I'm absolutely appalled, and I presume his friends would be also. It's a very disturbing situation, because it turns into a grudge, and I'm like, well, is the grudge because I lived in Europe so many years? And I missed out, you know, I missed out on a funeral, I missed out on weddings. Is this the grudge? Because that is small. That is not something I could afford to return to. You know, I could not afford it. So you can't keep that grudge on me. That's stupid. Is the grudge because I chose to marry a man from Europe? That's possible. You know, so I'm running through all of these things. You know, where is the grudge coming from? And yet at the back of my mind, it is coming from an addiction. It's coming from the addiction because the alcohol, the regular life that we used to have as friends just to go out to a restaurant is not available because I have made the decision not to drink so much. So it is a war. We're having a war then, aren't we? We're having a war, a family war over alcohol. And I am trying to push it away. And perhaps in that answer, that is one of the reasons. That is one of the reasons the frictions occur between brothers and sisters or brothers and brothers. It is the alcohol level, the party level, the amount of hey, you know, you're available to go here, you're available to go there. And at these moments, I will decipher you as my friend, or not your friend. And so what is the basis of accusation? When the person who is the alcoholic, is the accusatory, I'll claim myself as alcoholic also, but when the other person is accusatory towards you, and you're trying to abstain from drinking or any kind of excessives, it's difficult to abstain your temper, because they have changed. They have changed to bolster it. You know, they've changed. It's almost as if it's an incredible friend. It's an incredible friend that stands in front of them, between you and your sibling. An incredible friend. And it's an invisible friend, an addictive friend that says, that's it. I will do anything to block her because she cannot be near me because she does not want to drink. She cannot be near me because she does not want to go out late and party. She cannot be near me. So it's almost as if there's an invisible talker friend in front of him that it blocks our friendship. So I don't know how to regain it aside from perhaps maybe I help others and we'll deal with it. We'll deal with all of these people that have these extra extraordinary helpers that are not helpers. They're non-helpers. They're just they're degradants. They're negatives, derogatories. That are protectionism. That is a protectionism to their self. Protectionism, a wall. I have to always have, you know, my wine. I have to always have this drink or whatever. Yeah, I'm not supportive. I'm not supportive of it. So I guess that could be the major reason that our relationship has frayed to less. But how sad. How sad, really. How sad. I don't know. Maybe he watches this, maybe he doesn't, but in all reality and form, I also disrespect any friends of his, any liaisons with his, of his that participate in keeping him stirred under in his particular state of acceptance to these, what are they? They're kind of escape articles, escapisms. Yeah, I don't have an easy hello with those people because I feel they have hurt him. I feel they have hurt him, and in my protectionist state, he's my brother, I do not want the hurt going towards him. I don't want the hurt going towards him at all. So I don't support his friends or people who keep him supplied with any kind of addictive equipment. So yeah. So it is like now I've been thrust out into the raft, you know, myself, the raft on the sea. Like, what? How strange of you. You don't want to just drink beer and wine at the meal every day? How strange of you. You know, like a freak. Like, I'm now the freak person. Yeah, how upsetting. How upsetting, really. Well, anyway, the accusatory is an aggravator, and he will test you, or she will test you, and rile you, and bring your passions out, and your angries, and your aggressions. So watch these people, and I don't know, I would like to say stay away from them, but it's such a shock when they have flipped this much, because I have depended on him so tightly, you know, so tightly as just one of my most favorite persons on the entire planet. And when my most favorite person on the entire planet just is turned into a grump against me, I'm just in a state of shock. At a time when I actually need and require his help, he's turned into the opposite. So I'm extremely disappointed, extremely disappointed. I did do something fun today. I actually went to a Catholic church service. Don't laugh, but I sang, and it was fun it was shorter than the Mormon services, much shorter. And but oh my goodness, it was interesting. It was interesting. I don't think I'm a regular to go there, but I did enjoy the singing. It's a different quality in the voice, a lot lighter. Not Pergolosi's going on, but it was interesting. What can I say? Much shorter service than the Mormons. No testimonials, no like out there, you know, giving your confessions to the whole group. No Mormon missionaries showing up, talking and jabbering. No Relief Society discussions. So yeah, absolutely less. It was just quick. I was like, what? It's over. Because sometimes with church, you know, the Mormon church is just like moving in. You know, just move in. You know, you need the women wear the corsages just because. You know, it's like an all-day affair. Where, you know, my grandmother used to have this corsage, and all day long, it seemed like 3-hour service. So yeah. Anyway, that was interesting. Interesting. What else can I say aside from, yeah. Well, love to him, and I hope he can understand. Hope he can understand where he's coming from. That he is speaking through something else, you know, he's speaking his choices against me through something else. It's like he has this other voice that's trying to protect his addiction. Another voice, yeah.